Friends, we were doing estimation in welding and sheet metal shop. In the previous video, we solved two problems. I will solve some more problems in this video. I will take up this fourth problem now. Fourth problem, that is, it goes like this. A cylindrical boiler drum, 3 meter by 1 meter dia. 1 meter dia is to be fabricated from 1.5 centimeter thick MS plates or 15 mm thick MS plates. Both ends are closed by welding circular plates to them. The cylindrical portion is welded along the longitudinal seam. Both inside and outside, circular plates are welded on only one side. Determine the cost of electric arc welding using the following data. Number one, rate of welding, that is speed, welding speed. It can also be called as rate welding. 2 meters per hour. 2 meters per hour. For inside and 2.5 meters per hour for outside welding. Then length of electrode required is 2 meter long electrode per meter weld. For welding 1 meter length, you require 2 meter of electrode. Cost of electrode is rupees 6 per meter. Then power consumption. Fourth one, power consumption is 5 kilowatt hour per meter welding, per meter weld. Per meter weld, power charges rupees 2 per kilowatt hour or per unit. Labor charges rupees 10 per hour. Overhead charges 200% of prime cost. Discarded electrodes, that is thrown, wasted electrodes, or 5%. Fatigue and setting up time. Fatigue, that is extra time allowance. Fatigue and setting up time. Setting up time, 5% of welding time. 5% of welding time. From this data, we are asked to find the cost of this. Without the cost of plate, we are not going to put the plate. We are only going to find out the cost of welding, that is welding material here, that is the materials to be used are electrode and power. We are using electrodes and power. Cost of electrode, cost of power, then add them. That will give you the prime cost. Then after that, you know, then labor also you have to add. Electrode, electricity charges, power charges, electrode charges plus labor charges. If you add these three, you get the prime cost. Then material cost and labor cost together will give you the prime cost. Then you find out overheads, add the overheads to it, you will get it. Now, first of all, what we have to do here is, I'll draw a rough sketch. This is the boiler drum. This is the boiler drum that is to be used, that is to be done. Now, we are going to weld it here. We are going to weld it here. Say, I'll show you here. Say, this is the sheet. This is the sheet from which we are going to make this thing. We are going to roll it like this. You will get a cylindrical this thing. You are going to weld this. This is called seam. You are going to weld it here from outside also, from inside also. The length is 3 meters. The length of the vessel is 3 meters. The dia of the vessel is 1 meter. This diameter is 1 meter. You are going to take a circular plate, close this here. Here you are going to do only welding outside only. Here and here you are going to do welding outside only. Here you are going to do welding on both sides. This is first thing that you have to understand. Then you have to find out what is the length to be welded. Then we have to find out all these costs and add them. You will get the total cost. Total cost of welding. I think you have understood this. Now, length of welding outside, only outside, that will be L, that is length of this here, it is 3 meters, and this dia here, this is 1 meter dia, 1 meter dia. The length is 3 meters plus 2 times pi d, 2 times pi d. This length, pi d here, pi d on the back side, 2 times pi d. So that will be 3 plus 2 into pi into d is 1 meter. So this works out to 6.28, this is 3, 9.28 meters it will. This will be 9.28 meters. Length of welding, inside welding is, this is inside, will be only L. It is not there. If that is given, it will also be 9.8 meters. So it is 3 meters. This is 3 meters. Right. Now total length of welding is, total length of welding is outside and inside together 9.28 plus 3, that is 12.28 meters. Or you can say 12.3 meters also, 12.28 meters. Now, rate of welding is 2 meters per hour inside. So, welding time, that is time required to weld, is length of weld. This is, let me call it as outside welding. 9.28 divided by outside speed is 2.5. So 9.28 divided by 9.28 divided by 2.5, that is 3.72 hours. 3.72, 712, sorry, 712 hours. Welding time inside will be length of weld, inside weld, that is 3 meters divided by speed of welding is 2 meters. So this will be 1.5 meters, 1.5 hours. So total welding time will be, welding time will be outside welding, inside welding, that is 3.712 plus 1.5 plus fatigue time. Fatigue time is 5%, means 5 by 100, that is 0.05 into total, this total 3.712 plus 1.5. Are you understanding? This is this plus this into 5% of that, that is to be added to it. So 3.712 plus 1.5 will give you 5 point something into, I will do 1.05, that will give me about, roughly you can take it as 5.5 hours. This is the welding time required, 5.5 hours. Next, what we have to do? What we have to do is, we have to find out labor cost. We can get labor cost now. Labor cost is total time required into the charge paid per hour, that is 10 rupees per hour, so it will be rupees 55, it will be 55 rupees, labor cost will be 55 rupees. Now length of electrode required, length of electrode, electrode required will be total length to be welded, that is 12.28 meters multiplied by 2, because to weld 1 meter you require 2 meters, so into 2, that means it is 24.56 meters. Cost this plus plus you have to have 5% wastage also is to be added, 0.05 into, this will be 24.56 into 1.05 again. This will be 25.8 meters, approximately 25.8 meters. So 25.8 meters means cost of electrode will be, it is available at 6 rupees per meter. So 25.8 into 6, 25.8 multiplied by 6, that will be 154 rupees 80 paisa, 80 paisa, this is cost of electrode. Then power cost, power consumption is 5 kilowatt per hour, per meter. Power consumption will be, length to be welded, total length is 12.28 into 5, length to be welded into consumption per meter, that is 5 kilowatt hour per meter. So 12.28 into 5, that works out to 61.4 kilowatt hours. The cost of that power which we are using will be 61.4 kilowatt hours, and it is 2 rupees per kilowatt hour. So into 2, that works out to 122 rupees 80 paisa. So now prime cost will be labor cost plus cost of electrode plus cost of power, that is 55 rupees plus 154.80 plus 122.80. This is prime cost. So 55 plus 154.80 plus 122.80, that works out to 332 rupees 60 paisa. This is the total prime cost. Now overheads will be 200%, that means 2 into 200 divided by 100, that will be 2 into 332.60 paisa into 2, that will be 665 rupees 20 paisa. Now the total cost will be prime cost plus overheads, that is this plus this, 332.6 plus 665.2, that works out to plus 332.6, works out to 997.80, or approximately it will be 1000 rupees. Welding cost, total welding will cost you nearly 1000 rupees. So this is how it is to be done. I think you have followed it. We'll do one more problem. We'll solve one more problem. I have selected 7, problem number 7 from your question bank. It goes like this. An open water tank 1 meter by 1 meter by 2.5 meter height is to be fabricated from MS plates of thickness 2.5 centimeter thickness. Estimate the cost of the tank, of one tank, from the following data. Density of MS, let me call this as rho, is 8 grams per cc. Cost of mild steel plate, rupees 6 per kg. Cost of fabrication, 25% of material cost, 25% of material cost, MC. Cost of welding, rupees 0.25 per meter weld. Per meter weld. Factory overhead charges. Factory overhead charges are 30% of prime cost. 30% of prime cost. Okay. Sales overheads. Sales overheads. Overheads are 20% of manufacturing cost. Of manufacturing cost. Then profit is, profit required is 25% of total cost. 25% of total cost. So with this data we are asked to find the selling price, estimate the cost of tank, that is what rate we are going to sell it. Now it is better that we draw a rough sketch here, rough figure of the tank. So the tank is like this. This is the shape of the tank. This is the tank. This is the shape of the tank. It is 1 meter this way, 1 meter this way. Length 1 meter, this thing 1 meter. This height is 2.5 meter. 2.5 meter. Now in this problem we are putting the plate also. The plate also is ours. And we are putting the material, raw material, plus we are welding it and then this thing. So first we have to find the cost of plate. Now how many plates we will require? What is the size we will require? Now you have to have, to make a tank, we have to have four plates, four walls like this and a base. It is open tank, that means on the top it is open, but bottom it should be there, tank should be there. Now the material cost we have to find out. Now area of plate required will be, this is 2.5 meter by 1 meter, that means 250 centimeters into 100 centimeters. 250 centimeters into 100 centimeters. One meter means 100 centimeters. 2.5 meters means 250 centimeters. Such plates we require four. That is four vertical plates will be 100 by 250. You require four plates. Plus for the base you require one plate, 100 centimeter into 100 centimeter, one plate, so many square centimeter. Now volume will be area into thickness. So this 250 into 100 into 4 plus 100 into 100 into 1 multiplied by 2.5 centimeter. Thickness of the sheet is 2.5 centimeters. You will get this in cubic centimeters, cc. Right. So that works out to 250 into 100 into 4 plus 100 into 100 into 1 equals, this works out to 11,000, 1,10,000 into 2.5. This works out to 275 followed by 3 zeros. So many cc, 2,75,000 cc. Now weight of the sheet, weight of plate will be volume into density divided by 1000, so many kgs, that is 275,000 into 8 grams per cc divided by 1000. So this works out to into 8 divided by 1000. This works out to 2200 kg. Now, so cost of plate. Cost of plate. He hasn't given any wastage, cutting and all that. No wastage is given. So cost of plate will be weight into rate. Weight is 2200 kg. Multiplied by rate is 6 rupees multiplied by 6, that will give me 13,200 rupees. This is the cost of plate from which we are going to make this. Now, cost of fabrication means it includes cutting, welding, all that. That is power, all that will come in that. Fabrication means welding materials, all welding materials will be included there. So, cost of fabrication is 25% of this. 0.25 into 13,200, that is the plate cost, into 0.25, that works out to 3,300 rupees. Then this is done, plate is done, cost of fabrication is done. Cost of welding means that is labor cost. A labor cost is 25 paisa per meter of weld. For welding 1 meter, it costs 25 paisa, 0.25 rupees. So how many meters are to be welded? Length of weld is 2.5 meters, you have to weld 4. 1, 2, 3, here back, 4. 2.5 into 4 meters. Here plus 1 meter, 4 edges, whether it is to be welded both sides or one side, he hasn't given. So we'll assume that it is one side only. So many meters, that is 10 plus 4, 14 meters. So labor cost will be 14 into 0.25, that is 3.5 rupees. Then prime cost, this plus this. There is some mistake there. Maybe it is 25 rupees per meter, but it is printed as 0.25 per meter. It is 0.25 per centimeter length. I have made a mistake. So this is rupees 25 per meter. It is 0.25 rupees per centimeter. So for meter it becomes into 100. So it will be 25. 25 into 14 will give you How much? 350 rupees. 350 rupees. That is labor cost. So prime cost now will be, prime cost will be the cost of plate. Cost of plate. Prime cost will be cost of plate, that is 13,200 plus cost of fabrication, that is 3,300 plus 350, that is labor cost. These three if you add, you will get the prime cost. That works out to 13,200 plus 3,300 plus 350. That works out to 16,850 rupees. This is the prime cost. Now, factory overhead charges. Factory overhead charges are factory overhead charges, that is rent, indirect expenses, all indirect expenses included, is 30% of prime cost, that is 0.30 into prime cost is 16,850, so that will be into 0.3, that works out to 5,055. These are all indirect expenses. So this is done. Next, sales overheads. This is, if you add these two, you are going to get factory cost. Factory cost is, factory cost of the product is, factory cost will be prime cost plus factory overheads. So that is 16,850 plus 5,055. So this works out to plus 16,850. That works out to 21,905. 21,905 rupees. So this is the factory cost. To this factory cost, if I add what? Sales overheads. Sales overheads are 20% of factory cost, that is 21,905 into 0.2, that will give me 4,381 rupees. So total cost will be factory cost plus selling overheads, sales overheads. So that is 21,905 plus 4,381. It works out to plus 21,905. That works out to 26,286. 26,286. 26,286. So many rupees. Now we want a profit of 25% of total cost. So profit we require is 25% of total cost, that is 0.25 into 26,286. That works out to 0.25 into 26 to 86. That works out to 6,571 rupees 50 paise. So selling price will be total cost plus profit, that is 26,286 plus 6,571.5. So you have to sell it at this rate, plus 26,286. That works out to 32,857 rupees 50 paise. This is the problem. This is how it is to be done. Now, and there are some more problems which you can do. Let us see if we can do it in the next this thing. You please, if you have any problem, you can call me and ask for the doubts. Thank you.